Tell me, princess, when did you last let your heart decide? What the fuck, Celeste? I told you not to f-. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce Prince Ali Ababwa, or as you may know him better, Aladdin. Now, before you decide to turn this off, let me assure you that this is before a time when a licensed game like Aladdin for the Super Nintendo and a game like Superman 64 were one and the same. Ah, the good old days of 1992. Anyway, the story of Aladdin is nearly identical to the movie. For those of you unfamiliar with the story of the Disney film, you start out as a beggar on the streets, running from the guards in the market. This leads to Aladdin coming upon Jasmine and an angry shopkeeper that Aladdin must defeat to rescue the damsel in distress. Later on, Aladdin is captured and put in prison where Jafar disguises himself and tricks Al into spelunking into the Cave of Wonders to retrieve the magic lamp. He is then tricked by Jafar again and left to perish in the cave. Luckily, Abu has stolen the lamp back from Jafar and Aladdin rubs it. This releases the genie who is now loyal to Aladdin. The main difference from the game and the film is right here in the game, the genie invites Aladdin into his lamp. Once you are out of the lamp, you are then on your way back to Agrabah. Here is another departure from the story, as Abu falls off the carpet and Aladdin must go rescue him inside of a pyramid. Where the pyramid came from? Nobody knows. As soon as Abu is safe, you must now woo the beautiful Princess Jasmine on a magical carpet ride to the tune of A Whole New World. But wait, as soon as you deliver her home to the Sultan, she is taken and Aladdin is banished from the kingdom by the dastardly Jafar. When you get to Jafar, he has two stages. One is a powerful sorcerer with the ability to conjure enemies and shoot lightning from his snake staff. Once you jump on his head 4 or 5 times, Jafar transforms into a giant snake on top of a bed of fire. He wiggles his snake body and shoots big black acid balls at you that you must dodge, followed by a successful 4 or 5 jumps on his head. The game is broken up into 8 major locations with 2 or 3 sub-levels in each location. This allows a nice coverage of all of the environments in the movie without repeating any territory. This game looks great. The 16-bit generation will never go out of style, and since the game is officially licensed, it commands all of the assets from the movie, from the muscly look of the guards down to Jafar's pointy goatee. However, the game does lag a bit during the boss battle against Jafar's first stage when there are numerous enemies on the screen at one time. Being on Super Nintendo, this game did lack some of the graphical prowess and animation power of the Sega Genesis version, but I don't see that as a major hindrance. The game is not terribly hard in that it introduces a health system that grows as the game goes on. There is also a simple password system that allows the player to jump between levels via the main menu. Aladdin is a very nimble thief, so it only makes sense that this game takes the form of a platformer with some added elements of swinging on poles, chains, and ropes, using various objects as a springboard, and one of my all-time favorite game mechanics of using a stretched fabric like a freaking trampoline. The platforming works well enough, but it isn't quite as tight as any of the core Mario games at this time. There are some platforms where the ledge just isn't where it should be. There are times the game will give the player a lot of wiggle room on landings, and other times it doesn't seem like enough. And with the aforementioned springboards, the timing just seems to be arbitrary on how to get a reasonable jump off of them. There are also a few levels that incorporate the scrolling edge that pushes the player forward if forward progress is constantly made. The screen just doesn't seem to move fast enough for my taste, but this is a minor complaint. All in all, the platforming is still challenging enough to be fun, but not frustrating. The game tries to separate itself by incorporating the magic carpet. These parts of the games are complete. One of them has you escaping from the Cave of Wonders as it is collapsing. This segment is almost broken. It is not long or inherently difficult, but the problem is that you must stay abnormally close to the right side of the screen to avoid the constant lava tidal wave that is chasing you. This wouldn't be as bad if the magic carpet was nimble or quick like you would think it was. It controls like a f***ing tank, and the boundaries of rocks and other environmental hazards seem ambiguous at best. And it isn't because I suck at video games. I've beaten Turbo Tunnel on Battletoads, so get at me. Thankfully, the only other time this mechanic is used is when you are on the carpet ride with Jasmine. The main goal of this is only to collect gems, so it isn't a life-threatening situation, and I can mostly forgive that. As I said before, the game is not very challenging if you understand that platformers can become extremely frustrating if you don't take your time and be patient. The game is pretty short when compared to any Mario game. It can be completed in one sitting. All in all, the game is pretty darn good, especially considering if I saw a game today with the name Aladdin on it, other than Kingdom Hearts, I would most likely pass. And who doesn't love a happy ending where you get the pretty girl and live happily ever after? This has been another classic review by Alex Ram. Keep it real.